welcome to the Computer Lab Vids YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the rename feature built into Finder on your Mac. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is open a Finder window on the Mac so we can access the rename feature. So I've just got a window open with some files already shown here. These are typical when you import off a camera. They usually show with the IMG underscore and the number, depending on where you're up to on the camera and how many pictures you have. So the rename feature is really powerful, has some really good features. But although I'm only using JPEGs here, you can rename documents, anything you want. So if you have certain things that projects and you wanted to name it the project files or whatever it be, you can rename en masse and select what you want out of the folder that you have. So obviously open up your files that you want to rename, and then we need to select all or select a few. If you want to just select a few and you're unfamiliar with using your keyboard and how to select single and multiple items, a quick way to do it is select the from which file you want to start from. So let's say we want to start from 2139. Hold down the shift key on your keyboard, which is the one that points with the arrow up. Go down to where you want to finish your renaming, select them, and then anything that's in blue will be renamed once we go into that in a second. I want to rename them all, so I could do that, use the same way. Select the top one, hold down the shift key, select them all, and then that's all the items selected. Or if I want to use the top toolbar, up to the top toolbar, click on edit and then down to select all, and that will have the same effect and selecting everything that's in that folder that we're currently viewing. Okay, so now we have the file selected. Anything in blue that is selected is going to get renamed. A couple of ways to rename them. We can right click on the blue items, and then we have our menu here, which gives us rename 47 items. Or we can do the same again. Go up to file on the top toolbar and go to rename 47 items. So I'll click on this one, and then we now get presented with our option to rename the folders that we have selected. The first option, which is this one here where it says format, we'll start at the top and we'll go with the replace text. So what replace text does in Finder, it looks for a word that's in the items that you have selected. So for example, if I wanted to name everything in here with that is named IMG, and I want to replace it with the text test, for example. In fact, I'll rename it my channel. So anything that's got AMG, it's going to replace that word with whatever word we put in here. So you can see the example there, the computer lab underscore 2136, and it'll name them all. So we'll rename them all just so we can see what's going on. So if you keep your eye on these ones, you'll see how they rename. So there you go, anything that had IMG has now been replaced with my sample text, which is the computer lab, and then the number goes down there. So we'll again select them all and look for the next option. Go across, right click, rename 47 items. So that's the replace text option. Now we go down to the add text. So the really good thing and the powerful thing in the file rename that's built into the Mac is the way that it gives you multiple options to rename the files. So I'm in the add text option at the moment, so now I can add something to the file. So you can see that we already have the computer lab, then the number. And if I want it to say hello directly after it, you can see it's presenting an example there. The thing that really you need to do is obviously make sure you have used spaces or underscores, because if I left it blank, it sort of won't make no difference where it's 2136, won't make much sense if I did it that way. But if I like to use underscores, you can use space, but say for example, computer lab underscore 2136 underscore hello, and it will rename all the files. I can do this before or after the text. So if I change this one here, I want it to go before the name, you'll see that when I go before, it will put it actually before the actual file name. So now I have where it says hello underscore the computer lab. So we'll change all these, and then you can see it present it down here on the files that we have selected. So now all my files are renamed with that tool. Again, we need to select all the items, so select all that's in the file, right click, rename. So that's the add text function. Another format, which is the one that I tend to use the most, format, and then we have a couple of options once we're in format. So we'll start at the top, the name and the index. It's saying, where do you want to put the name? So let's say we want to rename them IMG. We want to underscore. We want to start the numbers at 2136. We'll start the numbers a bit, so you can see a bit easier. So we'll start the numbers at 1000. So the top one within our window here is going to be start at 1000. And then anything beyond that is just going to count down. And it's going to start the custom format, the name with IMG. So we'll rename. So now we're back to sort of how we were. Again, or to rename again. That was the name and index. Now I'm going to go to name and counter. So now you can see in the example straight away what it's going to do. You can start the numbers at whatever you want. If I leave that at zero, so it's now going to start with the file custom format we've left at IMG, and it's going to start numbers at zero. So it'll rename everything with a counter. And then the last option is the name and date. So again, you can see the custom format. It's got the name, it's going to be IMG because that's what we have in the custom format there. And then it's going to put today's date, not the date that the actual picture was taken. It's going to be the date that you change the file name to. So you can see that there the date, and at the time it was changed as well. You can again place this before the, if you keep it around here, you put it before or after the name. So let's put the date before or after if I want to rename it that way. And I can also change that text and it will call it there with the date. So whatever you put in the format there. So if I come back into the name and index one. So this is the one that I tend to use the most, like I said earlier. So here, you call it whatever you want. So I think the actual pictures, let me just have a look what they are. I think they're a Mac repair that I did. Yeah, it's where we installed an SSD into a Mac. So here I want to call all these folders. So if yours is a wedding, for example, you'd name it all wedding. Mine is a Mac repair. I want to start the numbers, I'll start them at zero. So it's telling me what exactly it's going to look here. So again, like I said, I like to use underscore. So I'm going to do Mac repair and then I'm going to underscore after. So it leaves a space between my numbering so I can see what's going on. And it'll start everything there. Incidentally, if you do want to put the number before, you could select it here, put the before name. So if you want to see a number, say for example, starting at one, and then I would change my space to the beginning of the custom format. So I get a gap between my number and what the word is, just so I can make sense of it a bit more when we look at them in a list. So I'll do it that way around, just so you can see, so it makes it easier to see. So you can see all the files are numbered and each one of them has got the custom text that I used. And you can obviously just flick through your pictures and see what's going on. Okay, so that's it. That's how to use the powerful tool, the powerful rename tool that's built into your Mac in Finder. A really good, handy tool to use. All built in as standard. You don't need to purchase any other item. So I hope this video has helped. If it has, please do give us a like and give us any comments below, and please do subscribe to my channel because it all helps keep the videos coming, and thank you very much for watching.